Hey guys, T2RX6 here, back for another third-party review, and I suppose we can call this a vintage third-party review, because these guys have been sitting in my closet unopened since December 2012, and I don't know why, because I was super excited to get these guys, because I love the Deluxe Insecticons, and I really think Fansproject did a great job with the head remolds and the weapon remolds to distinguish over their original, ninja Insecticons here. Just for reference, here they all are. And you can kind of see just, how enormously different they look. Probably Ransack being the one that looks the least changed, but, even he has some really nice changes. So before we get on with these guys, we'll look at this little card here. Unlike most, instead of coming with three cards, they come with one card featuring all of them. Nothing terribly special. Moving on. On to each of the toys, you can see that versus their NinjaBot counterparts, they do have different things. There is no bladed weapons or throwing stars or anything like that. These guys came with, an individual gun. This one is Chop Shop's, and he's got these extra little bits here, and all they do is peg on to the back here, these back legs. Now, the one thing I really like about these guys is because they have all that bug kibble, there's so many different ways you can orient that stuff to make them look completely different. Like the legs down versus the legs kind of splayed out or up. Totally changes the way the bot looks from the front. And these extra bits, of course, for Chop Shop, at least, are helping quite a bit. So yeah, just a quick look here so you can see the differences in their faces here. And Chop Shop does have a loose hand here. I don't exactly know why, but it does fall off. You could see, actually, it's a square peg, so it will not rotate on there. Your articulation on these guys, I think I showed them for the individual Insecticon reviews, but we'll go over it again. Head is on a slight ball joint. The way it's molded, it's kind of hard to do much with it, aside from the left and right movement. And a lot of these joints are pretty tight on these guys. Shoulders, you got the in and out here, but it's also on a ball joint, which you can move around a bit to make it look nicer. You can, of course, 360 if you really want to. You do have the bicep swivel up at the top here, the elbow swivel, and then the forearm is on a ball joint to get plenty of range of motion out of that. But I prefer to just kind of keep it this way because it's the only way that I can keep his hand facing up. You do have the waist articulation. The legs are ball jointed. Not a whole terrible large amount of motion, at least sideways on this, but the full range forward and back. And of course, a nice knee and the coveted ankle tilts. Always, nice to see that. And these will probably be a pain throughout the review. So on to teardown slash barrage here. You can just see how nice the differences are between him and the bombshell we've got going on here. I do have the repro labels on the original Insecticons, but you can still see just how differently they've been painted. Now, bombshell has the weapons he's holding in the chain are actually part of, his what makes the arms of, or the legs, I suppose, of his bug mode. So this guy did get the slight remold that he actually has the same as his lower legs here for the front. And he also has a cannon here that comes off, forms the front of the beetle. And this gun actually does push this in and fold this up. But the weird thing is, I can't find any place that it's supposed to peg in. I see this channel right here, which seems to indicate that it would peg somewhere, but I'm not entirely sure that where that is. So if you guys know where that is, let me know. Maybe when we're going back to his bug mode, it'll be apparent. But I was looking for it this morning, and it's not in the instructions. And at least right now, at this point in the review, I still don't know where that goes. So yeah, you just kind of plug this in to make his gun. Pretty cool. Articulation on this guy. You do have these. These are the biggest pain in the butt because they do like to pop out. But anyway, his arm is on the swivel up here to go up and down. Nice range of motion to the side. Of course, the 360, the forearm, elbow, the forearm swivel, or bicep swivel, I should say, and the forearm's on the ball joint. Again, the waist, which you want to make sure you have it pushed down because it will pull up in robot mode. down to the legs, again, the ball joint, and because they're formed differently than they were on Chop Shop, you get much more greater range of motion out of that, the ankle tilts, and of course, the knee. So, yeah, pretty standard stuff here. And moving on to my sort of favorite and my least favorite. Favorite because I really like how he looks. Least favorite because the way he's made, some of the things are a bit fiddly on him. But this is the Ransack. And here he is. We'll bring in Kickback here. And you can see just how different. Again, the Repro labels do fill in these extra vents, but that's cool. I like how that looks. Makes him look much different. This is the one I think you can get the least number of differences, just because it's really hard to position the wings on this guy in a way that actually look pretty good. But yeah, you can see we don't have the knives anymore. We just have this blaster here. Again, for our articulation on these guys, you got the head on a ball joint. Nice range of motion here out of shoulder because of the ball joint. The double jointed elbow. The wrist do actually move this time because they are ball-jointed. Ball-jointed legs here. Unfortunately, with these particular ones, they kind of suffer the same thing that Chop Shop did, and they don't extend too far. No waist articulation, knee, and then, of course, the ankle tilts. So let's go and get these guys transformed, and we'll start with Ransack here, because in my opinion, he's still my least favorite to transform. We're going to take these and flip this around. Bring the bug head on up, plug it on in, flip the antenna, bring the wings to the other side here, and we can flip them all the way around on both accounts, like so. Next, we will take the legs here, kind of pull down on them a little, and separate, like so, just to get them out of that little groove, and basically make them do a split like that. Now we're going to kind of get these bug legs out of the way here as best as we can, and then we take the arms, pull them out of this with the ball joint, and swing it all the way around up to the top here. So now that we got this, the next thing to do is going to be to take these shoulder pads, flip them on out, flip them around, and then close them back up again as best you can. So flip it around, close it back up. Come to the hands here, bring the hands up so they're 90 degrees with their arms. And then what we do, and this is why I don't like this guy, he's a little messy. We lost one of his hands, we'll put that back after. Flip this around like so, and flip it so that facing inward here, you've got the small edge and the arms like this. Just kind of fold this all together, and you can see that by doing that, that little piece here kind of fits in the recessed piece. So we'll just do that again real quick on this side here. And our hands face straight up. And this should let us, we can see from the back here, plug the hands in together, and then once they're in, just kind of hold on to them a little and plug the back piece together like so. So you should end up with something that looks kind of like this. And in the process, our head came undone, so we'll replug that back in. And we might as well get our leg that fell off and just push that back in the ball joint. So now what we're going to do is take this, bring this down, and we'll further lock it in by basically making a 90 with these yellow pieces to the gray piece here, and they're going to plug into the little tabs here that were on the side of the forearms, and that's going to help secure this whole thing together a little bit tighter. There we go. Now we'll just take the arms, or the legs, I should say, and I kind of swing them on out. And see, this is why I don't particularly like this one, because everything just kind of came undone when we're trying to move it. So once again, I'll plug all this stuff back in together, then plug this back in, like that, and like that, and like that. Alright, so we got that. Now we're going to take the legs, kind of fold them like this, and what you have to do is pop these little panels off. Now, one thing that's not built as good about these is you can see that this actually pulls the plastic away. It's not supposed to do that, so you gotta kind of hold that together and get your finger in there in such a way that you can, you know, hold this piece. Alright, sorry about that. Postman came and rang the doorbell and dog started flipping out. Anyway, hopefully we're right where I left off. You have to hold these little yellow pieces a bit and kind of pull them out there, at least until it loosens up. You could probably also file away a little bit. But anyway, once you have this undone, you're just going to rotate the leg until you get it to the position that it is spaced right, and then just plug those panels into the top of the leg here. Come on, piece. There we go. And then what you'll do here is keep the foot out, rotate this whole assembly on around, push the foot on through all the way as far as you can go with this, and then take it and fold the foot up, pull the little insect leg on out, and then we'll do that for the other side here. And then it's just kind of a matter of positioning things. Alright, let's bring these back up again. So there we go. And you can see we just kind of straighten everything out. Then we bring the insect legs on around and up into the side sockets here. And then it's just really all it is a matter of positioning the legs how you want them. Like so. Something like this. We'll make sure that he kind of stands when he's on the ground here. He's looking pretty good. And what they tell you to do with this gun is actually just take it and peg it into his leg here. And this one's actually in the instructions that way. So you basically take what was holding those little kunais and you plug it in here. I don't find that to be, you know, I guess it works. Doesn't look particularly good, but whatever. We'll put him to the side. So next, we'll come to Chop Shop here, who is much easier to transform. We'll start by taking the gun out, then we'll come over here. We'll rip his hand out again. I think I need to get some glue in there to stop that from happening. Pull out these two arm bracer things. Put his fist back in. Like so. Then take these two pieces off and we'll put them to the side for now. What you're gonna do, and you still may want to file these down because it is still fairly tight, but you slide them on in like that so you have the stripe piece up. I'll do it again for this side. There we go. Take all this stuff, put it somewhere else, and let's get on the actual Chop Shop himself. We're going to start by sliding his legs forward, like that, and then flip him around to the other side here. Now we can take this cockpity type piece and close it on up, like so. Bring the legs down here. Flip the shoulders so they rotate like this. And then we'll come to the feet. These are the hardest part of this particular mold, is to take this out and rotate the foot at the same time as you're doing it. And then once you get it around all the way, hopefully, which they do like to get caught up a little bit. There we go. You're gonna take it and just plug it into that big tab sticking out the side here, like this. So we'll do that again. Over here, like this, bring it all the way around, plug it on in, and we're good to go. So we'll leave this like that for now, And what we'll do is take the arms and bring them all the way around and back. And you can see that the shoulders have that channel carved out for this piece here. So bring them around and back. Make sure that the forearm piece can bend while the elbow can bend downwards like this. And just kind of leave it like that. So we'll do that again for this side. Swing it around, bring it up. There we go. So now what we're going to do is take this and tuck his hand in here as we're folding this around. Make sure your legs are out of the way so you can work with it. But get his hand in there, and it should go over the knee joint in the back there all the way around. And then that'll end up plugging into the tabs here on the side of his crotch piece. So we'll do that again one more time. Make sure it's over the knee. Rotate this around. Like so. All the way. And make sure that it plugs in. So there you go. You got the hands. They'll hang out the back and they'll look like this. And he's pretty well done. To store his weapon, all they tell you to do with this one is to take it and take the like bar piece here and just kind of put it between the two little, tab it into the little tab here, which doesn't hold too terribly well. I mean, it's good enough, but yeah, it just hangs off like that. So then you just take his feet here. And we'll take them and push them up, and they have little tabs to plug into little pieces on the side of the body here. You can better see them when you look here. You take them and just kind of plug them in like so. And then we'll just situate them in such a way that we think looks okay. Like that, I think looks pretty good. We take his little pincher pieces. And we plug it into the little clips here, like so. And there we go. There's Chop Shop, and he's done. And now we'll take the very last one, Teardown slash Barrage here, and I find him to be the absolute easiest, although he does have some things that are a little bit of a pain. So we'll first start by bringing this up. And make sure you don't catch any of his little spiky pieces in here. But just take it, fold it on closed, like so. We can, while we're at it, we'll take the gun apart, fold this down, fold this in. And let's see if we find a place for this as we're doing this. We can also plug the front in here to make the front of his beetle form. Then what we're going to do is come to these pieces here. Make sure he's kind of pulled apart. Like that, and just bring all these panels on up. They're just on swivels, nothing really fancy. And then flip his legs to the side, so you have the forward parts of his thighs actually up there. We'll take these and just kind of move them out of the way for now. You'll want to take the feet here, rotate this on in, so the toe is facing inwards, and close that heel spur piece on him. Again, I'll do that here. Toe rotated in, heel spur comes in on him. And then you want to carefully, so you don't pinch your finger, push these on up until they will click. Sometimes a little louder than others. There we go. And then we can take these and connect them together. Give it one more push to make sure everything is locked into position there. And that is set. So we'll take these feet and just kind of rotate them around. Open the little bottom portions of the feet. There we go. Now this is what I would consider my least favorite part. So we'll take these little pieces that swing up out of here. And you've got to push this open here. And you can see you're on this little piece, and this piece just loves to pop off the shoulder bits like that when you're trying to work with it. So just be aware, it's real easy to fix. But take this, put your two fingers on there, it helps keep it from popping off, and flip it on around, and then close it back up like so. And then we'll do that again for this other side. Take it, flip it around, close it back up, and then swing the arms on in like this. And you'll see that it kind of, you know, this recess on his back that looked a little bit ugly in robot mode is designed to fit it perfectly. Then all you're going to do is take his forearms here and plug them into the bottom of the beetle here. If you have his arm the right way, that is. And that'll close on up like so. And his feet, for whatever reason, weren't all the way in. But there we go. We got this. We'll open up his feet. And there we go. We've got him in his beetle mode. And I still am not sure where the gun goes. I suppose maybe doesn't feel like it. Let's see, maybe if we open one of these feet, you can maybe plug it in here. There you go. You could store it like that, I suppose, if you really want. I guess it doesn't look horrible if you leave the toes open on this particular beetle mode. No instructions to tell you, that the instructions don't tell you where you should plug it in. That seems like the only logical place. Actually, what about if we plug it in right here? There we go. Perfect. So we found out the place where it goes and plugs in. So there we go. We have him in his beetle mode. And this is our set of deluxe Insecticons here in their bug modes. So let's just take a look real quick. Ransack and Bombshell here, just so you guys can see the difference. Pretty cool. Very nice change with the remolds there. We'll then take Chop Shop and Shrapnel. Again, real nice with the remold changes. And finally, we'll take Ransack and Kickback, who look a lot less different just because there's no real remolded bits except for the guns. So, yeah, overall, I think that this is a great set. Even though it is 2 years old now, surprisingly, you can still have these Deluxe Insecticons at a decent price. So, if you are a fan of the Deluxe Insecticons, I think they're worth picking up because they are some pretty fun molds, to be completely honest. So, this is T2RX6. I hope that this didn't run on too long. I had a couple issues along the way, but yeah. There's some big stuff coming next week, getting a pile of loot shipment in on Monday, which has like Scoria and some more impossible toys, so I'm real excited to have two more impossible toys to show you guys. A lot of new things coming up, so stay tuned, guys, and actually we're going to do a bonus today.